Hi there. In this quick video, I thought I would talk about my experiences freelancing with Blender to create CGI and how I work with clients. So initially, you need that first contact from a potential client. First of all, I make sure that I have a presence in lots of different medias such as ArtStation, Facebook, Twitter, and so on. So there's lots of ways that potential clients can reach me. Another key thing about things like Twitter is make sure you check your messages. It's all too easy, if you don't check them regularly, to completely miss an inquiry from a client, or for that matter, from someone who just needs some help. Once you've been contacted by a client, make sure that you spend a reasonable amount of time talking to them and understanding what their expectations are. I'll usually sit down, usually on a Skype call or something like that, and just talk through what it is that they would like to achieve, what they're looking for. I really need to understand their expectations, because some clients will have no idea really on what can be created with Blender and computer graphics and may have unreasonably high expectations of what they could have. Others will know exactly what they want and will be just looking for someone to do the work for them, to give them whatever it is. Make sure you document your discussion with them so that you can go back over it and use it as a reference as you're creating initially an estimate for the work and then later the work itself. What I'm trying to establish is, can I realistically produce what they're looking for? And if not, can I offer an alternative? If the answer to both those questions is no, then obviously I need to tell them that straight away so that neither of us waste our time. The detailed discussion on the requirements obviously needs to establish whether they're just looking for a still image or whether they're looking for an animation. Typically it's an animation. What are they going to use it for? So if it's for a website, it may be that it's not a standard size. It might be a header on a web page or something like that. So you need to know that. If it's for a movie of some kind, then it probably needs to be quite high resolution. Do they want it to be photorealistic or are they looking for a stylized look? How long is it going to be? That's obviously critical for an animation, as at a minimum you're going to have 25 frames per second. And that leads me to the next element, which is the quality of it. Do they want 25 frames a second? Are they happy with less, which they may be for a website, for example? Or do they need higher than that? They might need 60 frames or more. And that obviously significantly alters the amount of rendering that you're going to need to do. And then on top of that, obviously, we've got the resolution of the end product. What are they looking for there? If it's a small section of a website, it might be relatively low. If it's for a movie, it could be quite high. It could be 4K, for example. So you very much need to understand what it is that the client needs so that you can give them a guide on what might be involved and obviously understand whether you're able to do it. Using that information, you should be able to generate a cost estimate. Now, we each have to decide for ourselves what we should charge. I strongly recommend against charging nothing. The exception I make to that is generally if it's for an educational institution or something like that, I'm more than happy as long as they give me credit and generally to do that for nothing. But other than that, I normally charge something. The exact amount you charge obviously is going to vary by what the work is that's required to do it. It needs to be reasonable and it needs to be scaled with your own capabilities and what you're going to produce at the end of it and what they're asking you to produce. So a simple animation is obviously going to cost a lot less than a more complex one. But, you know, starting out in the business, you don't want to price yourself out of the market. The reason for not charging nothing because you want the experience or you want to get your name out there is because by charging nothing, you are effectively saying your work isn't worth charging for. So it's important that you charge something. That doesn't mean that because you charge $1,000 an hour, it's worth $1,000 an hour. But it does mean if you charged $5 an hour, it's worth something compared to not charging anything. I spoke in dollars, I normally charge in pounds. So have a think about how you want to charge. Decide on what sort of fee you want to charge. My general approach is to have a general amount that I will charge to do any work. And then I look at how much work is involved. And if it's going to be an awful lot of work, then I'll work out a per hour charge on top of that. And then whichever the greater of the two estimates is the one that gets provided. The actual numbers will obviously vary by task, and it's up to the individual as to what they want to charge there. At the end of the day, I'm doing it because I enjoy doing it, so I don't charge an awful lot of money, but that doesn't mean, as I say, that I charge nothing. Once you've generated your cost estimate, you need to make sure that when you communicate them to your customer, you caveat those costs. It's only an estimate because obviously things can evolve. Once you've given the client the first idea of what it is you're creating, they may change as to what they want. It could change completely, or it may just be that they want some additional elements added to the scene, which could increase the amount of time. So you need to caveat it a bit and just say, if there is a lot of go rounds, if I need to restart from scratch again a number of times, these costs can be greater. And you need to assess whenever that conversation starts to happen, whether what they're asking is going to be so much additional work that you feel you need to charge them more. You need to say that at that time. But you also need to allow for a little bit of that in your initial cost estimate, because it's very unusual that they're going to say what they want, you're going to put it together, they're happy and away they go. Normally there will be some back and forth because they want something tweaked, they don't like color, they'd like it a higher resolution, whatever it is. So make sure there's hours in your estimate to do that. I normally allow for 2 to 3 go rounds with the client to improve and correct issues. Once you've agreed on the cost, make sure that you've also agreed on a schedule. So typically most clients know these things can't be done instantly, but sometimes their expectations can be unrealistic. If they want a 4-minute animation and it's a high resolution one, it could take several days just to produce a low resolution sample of that animation. So you need to set their expectations there. And of course, if they're asking you to do something which is pushing your skills a little bit, there may need to be a little bit of time in order for you to develop how you're going to solve the problem they've set you. I never expect any payment up front. That's just the way I work at the moment. I'm not investing anything more than my time to do this. So yes, I could lose out at the end of it, and have done from time to time, having spent some time on a task and then end up with nothing, but it's just my time that I've lost. It isn't any significant amount of money or any money that I've spent on it other than electricity for the computer. Once you've agreed on the estimate, once we think the client understands the caveats on that estimate and you've agreed on an initial, at least, schedule for you to give them a sample, you can then begin work. And what I normally do is, once I've produced something, I will provide the client with a reduced quality version of the end result. And this is when we can actually get into a blender a little bit here, and I can show you what you can do to make sure when you're providing the client with samples that you're not effectively giving them what they need for free. So in here, under the output properties, you'll notice there's a metadata option. First of all, I would say set it to a reduced quality. So set it to at least 50% of whatever the desired quality is, maybe even 25. That'll mean it'll render a lot faster as well, of course, but it also ensures that you're not just giving away your work for nothing. So then under metadata, you can see by default a number of things are tick. And if you come down here and select burn into image, when I render, you'll notice I've got all of this data come up as well. And that's actually useful, as well as making sure that this isn't really usable in whatever their end application was. You can also adjust the font size here. So I'm just going to turn that down a little bit and just re-render that. Perhaps we'll go for 20. So you can see we've got the name of the scene there, the name of the camera, the frame number, that's a very useful one, time code and so on. And that's very useful so that if the customer has a problem with a particular point or a particular frame in the animation, it's easy for them to tell you exactly where it's a problem. And then if you want to, you can also turn note on and you can add something in here. So if I render that now, you see I've got SardiPax demo 1 coming up as well. And that's burned into the video itself. So short of cropping the video very tight, they're not going to have anything that's of any real use to them for their end application there necessarily. Once the client is happy with that, I will send them an invoice and I'll ask them to make payment. I normally use PayPal for that. Once I've received payment and have confirmed it, what I'll normally then do is upload the final version of my file into something like Google Drive. I will send them a link and they can then download it at their leisure. It's not uncommon for there to be a request for small tweaks, even though they've seen preview versions, once they've got the higher resolution version. And if it's just minor things, I'm not really going to charge them for that. So I'll normally just do a little tweak on it and away they go. I normally make sure that I keep both the blend files and the output files for quite some time afterward in case the client comes back and wants some additional work or wants some altered version of it. And I've done this a few times over the last few years, and as far as I'm aware, the clients have been happy with what they've got. By following that process, you should be making sure that you don't take on work that you can't achieve, that you don't disappoint your clients, and that your clients, if they want the work that you've produced, actually have to pay you. Now, it might be that you go through all the work, you get to the point where you've rendered the final version and you're just waiting for them to pay the invoice, and they don't pay that invoice. I haven't had that to date, but then I spend enough time with the client that it's clear whether or not we both are able to achieve what we want to achieve. I've had the odd occasion where after we've had a conversation, clients decided not to carry on. And that's absolutely fine for both of us. The worst can happen in that you end up having an end product ready and the client doesn't pay? Well, at least you know you haven't given your work away for nothing, at least not in any reasonable quality at least. So if you've got any questions about any of that, feel free to put comments below the video. You may have different approaches to doing it. But just to summarize, as I say, make sure you understand the requirements, make sure you communicate to the customer what you can do, how long it's going to take you to do it, and what you expect in terms of payment and so on. Make sure you give the customer plenty of samples, demonstrations as you go along so they understand what they should know before you send the final file. They should already have seen essentially the whole thing, and all they're waiting for now is the high quality version without all this text all around it. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you like this kind of video, if there's other subjects that you'd like me to talk about. But this was my experience of freelancing. If you enjoy my videos, don't forget to click like and subscribe. It really does help me out. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.